our birthday. Lady boy, come. Somebody give my first lady a good. Yeah. God bless you. Amen. Come around here.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you?
Well, we first of all, in Faith Clinic today, you were awesome. I mean, everybody that was in here. We were in here working and getting ready to go live. And so those of you that you're not aware, at New Greater Bethel, every Tuesday at 12 noon, our First Lady carried the Faith Clinic. But today, I came in here and was dealing with some things, and the door was open, and I'm like, she gonna get some ties and offering for that. You talk that faith about staying marinated until God gets through, and how the Lord has not forgotten about you. And she was saying that the more you complain, she said, even if you don't do it verbally, but the more you complain in your spirit, then you God gonna sit there and let you marinate some more.
Right.
But that was so powerful.
I don't mind waiting.
Yeah,
gonna wait. Even if you mind or you don't mind.
That's right.
And it's nothing like being in the season when God has you marinating. You know, we're getting older. Matter of fact, your birthday is next week. Mine's is next month. And when you get in this age, you start worrying about aging. But in this season, you're not aging, you're just marinating.
Okay, I take that. We were talking about the vegan thing, and I just wanted to pop you in here a few minutes to kind of share with people your transition on the fast and how the fast is really affecting your life and how it's affecting the life of your family, because I'm trying to get people to understand that this fast, I'm telling you, is one of the most important fasts you have ever gone on. Because if ever you're going to switch over, if ever God is going to bring into your life what the Lord has promised, you have to be aligned and you have to be healthy enough to be able to handle that.
Amen.
Because success comes with pressure. And if your nervous system is already shot from all the stuff that you're putting in it and chemicals, you will not be able to handle the stress of a successful business. You certainly won't be able to handle the stress of having money. Because people think, if I get some money, it's over with. But having money is pressure.
Amen.
Having money is pressure. And so you have got to hear all of what God is doing. That's why we're sitting here every day. That's
Amen.
Why Pastor and I have made a decision to sit here on this program for these 21 days. This is not easy for us to do this, but I believe it is not only your time, but it is your turn.
Yes.
Yes. Lady boy, tell us, how have this fast and just going vegan helped you out since you've been just going with no meat?
Well, I've been doing it now for 6 weeks. And we started right after Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
Janelle, matter of fact, my daughter started first. And we were talking about it. And so she stepped out. And then it kind of made me want to step out, you know. But I had been cooking in mine, you know, taking care of her and my husband, you know. But I'm feeling better. I feel that my voice, you know, because there's certain things that I do in the morning, you know, with certain drinks that I drink.
Mm-hmm.
And it's no meat, and I feel good.
Wow.
I mean, you know me, I don't play with my food, honey. No, I don't play with my food, and I'm the kind of person, it wasn't always easy for me to fast with her, because we was best friends for some 30 years. She could fast without a blink.
And she always had to eat a half a sandwich.
Yeah.
That was her thing.
But see, God had to work on me. And
so you can marinate a little bit.
Yeah. And I found out too, you know, that was her anointing, you know, and I had to eventually get up there, but I did it. It took a while. Some does overnight and some we gradually get there.
Right.
But I'm feeling good. I'm feeling good. And I'm excited because I'm getting older. I'm not going to tell you my age, but I'm old enough. But I believe that God has great things in store for me, and I want to be ready to embrace feeling good, you know, ready to get on the plane again. I mean, you know, it's like in the last year or so, more than ever, people have been calling me out and saying, God said, get ready to get back traveling and on the road, going overseas in your suitcase. I said, God, at this age?
Mm-hmm.
God, am I ready for this?
Right.
And I find that when you start eating right and just preparing your right, going to the gym, getting exercise, you'll be surprised how good you feel.
Right.
We can have faith all we want to, but you got to put some works with that.
Yes.
You got to put shoes on faith. You got to make faith work.
Yes.
So faith without works is dead. So these works with my husband having us on this fast, he's on the fast.
Absolutely.
I'm on somebody.
Absolutely.
And
but also, you did a great job. I mean, even just before the fast started, all December, you were cooking, you know, vegetable. You really started it, Janelle. So it really is. It becomes a lifestyle. It's what everybody is doing. But again, I was just saying how blessed we were with Prophetess and this really New Year's. When she preached that message, how many lives were just...
It's like, the way I look at food, I don't look at it anymore. Somebody at my house the other day kind of ordered some pizza.
Hold on a minute. Corey? Okay, we're back on. Okay, the devil. The devil didn't want somebody that is over 55 to hear this. So now, Lady Boy. Yeah. You still look good.
That's me.
You better tell your own story. I'm over here. Hello.
I said over 55.
I didn't want that. But hallelujah, she said it anyway. Okay. But, yeah, over 55.
It cut off when you were saying your daughter embraced it first and then you go from there.
My daughter embraced it first and I embraced it. We were talking about it, but she really put it in my spirit because sometimes things got to marinate in your spirit.
Yes.
So, and I said to her, I said, you know what? I'm going to cook enough that you and I will be able to eat and you don't have to worry about doing your own little foods. I said, because right now we don't know if pasta's in it. Because, you know, he was talking about eating a little chicken. I'm exposed.
Everybody's there real under bus today.
Tell on him.
Yeah. Okay.
No, he wasn't behind my back sitting on my show talking about eating
some chicken. No. Not since I've been on the show, no.
Okay, not since you've been on the show?
No, I haven't done that.
Not since you've been on the show this week.
Okay.
No, Val.
We're going to do this. We're going to do this right.
No, Val, wait a minute. Val, hold on.
Because, you know, he's been preaching about manna.
Right.
I said, so we're going to make sure you get some manna. And what's some other season he said he got?
Coriander.
We're going to have some coriander and some manna.
Wait. We've been on a fast since the first. I ain't touched a stick of meat.
The first of the year.
Yeah.
Oh, no, yeah. I'm talking about before that.
Okay.
But, you know, he was kind of battling a little bit.
I was. All right.
So me and my daughter, we said, we ain't going back. I said, you know, we ain't going back. We may eat a little fish, but we ain't going chicken because you were saying, and I've gone to the store, and I've seen them chickens up there looking like turkeys.
Yeah.
I said, okay, that's too much chicken. And I want to live so God can use me anywhere.
That's right.
But anyway, but I'm happy that I'm doing this. I feel that I look better.
Yeah.
What you think?
You're beautiful.
And
now they want to come on my show and do the You Look Beautiful Baby thing. This is not a love connection show. This is about food, people.
But it's good when you are able to change your eating habits for the betterment of your body.
Yes.
We're all getting older. And I want to live to be healthy. I don't want to be living and be having all kind of ailments of what I'm eating.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I believe that God can help you. You know, we can do all things through Christ that gives us the strength.
Right.
And I believe that if you put him at his word and say, God, you promised me that you would give me the strength. God, I can't put down this turkey leg yet.
That's right.
But God, I believe that he will change it. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I may eat a little fish every once in a while, but that's unbelievable because I was a pork eater.
No, I know.
Do you know?
Yes.
Oh, every morning I had to have bacon.
Well, do you remember? That's how I got.
Because
I came to New York as a vegan.
You.
Remember?
I was
a vegan. She had a barbecue and passed by me with a plate of ribs. I'll never forget it. And I said, that looks so good. Ate the ribs and have been eating meat ever since. I mean,
like pork ribs?
Yeah.
But I was a pork eater. I'm from down south, and they believe in pork. Porky pig, pork. And more pork. The more bacon you have, the better it is, you know. But for me, and even though God has changed me, the only thing that I crave for sometime is the bacon.
Mm-hmm.
And the longer I stay on this fast, it's lessening some.
Well, do you know Darius the
I'm gonna say that. Yes.
He did this the other morning. If you go to the VIP page, the VIP, Juanita Bynum, mm-hmm. scroll down. He did a video where he cooked plant-based vegan bacon, and Darius is an eater, and he literally swore by it.
Yeah. There's a plant-based
bacon. A plant-based bacon that smelled like bacon. He said even the texture.
Taste was bacon.
He said, no, I can't tell.
We need to get some. We are destroyed. Well, the lack, somebody say the lack.
The
lack of knowledge. No, no,
but
seriously.
On his page, the recipes that are on the VIP page, uh-huh. every single day, he made a commitment to cook vegan for 30 days straight. The recipes on there are incredible.
Wow.
I mean, and he is a down south black folk cook from Chicago.
Okay, well,
so he has to
him.
Have soul. His vegan food is soul food. That's what he specializes
okay,
in. People, you're watching, go visit mm-hmm. Darius Cooks, DariusCooks.com. Mm-hmm. He specializes in making vegan food taste like soul food. But this month, he's doing it every day. And on there, I believe, what day that was we went downtown?
That was on Friday?
Friday? Saturday.
Saturday.
Saturday. It yeah. was Saturday morning.
Yep.
We went downtown, mm-hmm. and we had to go down there to a warehouse. And we watched him in the car on our way to the warehouse. And he was cooking that vegan bacon. And I'm telling you, he said, this vegan bacon is okay. He
well,
said,
okay,
and
I get
it tastes like it.
Go to the website.
Yeah, go to his website and yeah, oh, go to the VIP
bacon,
page.
He
named what brand it was,
mm-hmm.
and so you can get it there. But I just want a witness before you go, Lady Boy, about my vegan food on Thanksgiving and how everybody was trying to chow up on the vegan food you cooked me, and they didn't want. We talking about somebody that's standing to your left and mm-hmm. my wife, who kept eating my greens, but yeah. wasn't it good?
No, it was good, and I made two kind of greens. I made the green greens and the vegan greens.
Tell them how you made the vegan greens.
And, you know, she stresses the liquid smoked. And, of course, you know, I put a little salt in it and a little seasoning and stuff like that. But when it was finished, we were doing a tasting test, and we was loving your greens better than
it's true.
Our greens. You know, I put a little something. I don't want to tell y'all my recipe because y'all be the main recipe. But I put my seasonings in there, and at the end of the day, you know, she was stressing it. Ain't my greens better than yours? I hated to say it, but I said
they were.
But ever since then, we've been kind of making the greens like vegan greens. I gather,
Yeah,
you know, so it's amazing what you can do.
Right.
But at the end of the day, you want to save yourself. You want to save your body. You want to live.
That's
you
right.
don't want to be in a sick, fested body and trying to make it the best you can, trying to preach, teach, sing, and they got to wheel you off when you get through and hoping that you don't fall out.
That's right.
That is not a God kind of way of living.
Amen.
No, it's not.
Amen. God wants us healthy. Wise and wealthy and everything that goes with it. He's a complete God.
Yes, he is.
And so this year, I'm doing that.
Listen, we're getting ready. I think getting ready to get Darius up on the phone.
Yes, we're getting ready to get Darius on the line.
Yeah.
And I'm telling you all, let me tell you what I want you to do. I want you to close your eyes for a second. Everybody just close your eyes for a second. And then I want you to put both of your hands up like you're getting ready to praise the Lord. Just put both of your hands up. And then I want you to imagine yourself, get a picture of your own self that's like maybe 2 inches tall. Minimize yourself to about 2 inches tall.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you ready? Now, what I want you to do is start doing the happy dance, like going back and forth, like waving your body back and forth, okay? Okay, you doing it? You doing it? The audience is doing it? Come on, look happy. You're not looking happy. You got to put a smile on your face. Close your eyes and put a smile on your face and do the happy move. Okay, you know what that is, Pastor?
What's that?
That's the real you doing the happy dance when you eat right. Yeah, that's the real you going, wow, we did it. I'm happy. Because you're making your insides happy when you eat the right thing.
You
Lady
do.
Boy, go with us. Because you stand up there looking all deep like,
yeah.
like okay, what, is this spiritual?
I mean,
no, it's the happy dance. Every time
you,
every time you eat,
with it?
Not
it's
taking
like
it.
Little...
Every time you eat healthy, it's going to be a happy dance. You know, is you're making your body happy. You're making healthy. Your spirit happy. Come on, somebody, because I'm eating right.
No, you're right. No, you're right.
I'm eating right. When you get through eating your plate, whatever it is, you should be able to get finished eating and all of a sudden just feel like, wow, I did that. That's the way I feel. I feel like I did that. I just put something in my body that's getting ready to make my body work like I want it to work. And that's why January the 16th,
yes,
my birth date, our birth date, January the 16th, I am going to be e-blasting out your birth certificates to everybody that have signed up at Back to Vegan, backtovegan.com. Go there and join us. I'm going with you, Dr. Bynum, for 21 days, and then I'm going with you for the first quarter. The first quarter is the first 90 days, and with the 21 days are inclusive. So on the 21st, on the 21st, we're doing the 21 to Life program. I'm doing it with Pastor. I'm doing it with Dr. Johnson. And Lady Boyd, while you're standing here, we're going to ask you the big question in a few minutes. But if you want to be a part, I'm telling you, just give me 21 days. That's all I'm asking. Give me 21 days that you would do this for 21 days. And then let me tell you, your life is going to change. Everybody that's deciding to go with us on the 21 to Life, I'm giving you a brand new birth certificate. That's right. We're going to shoot that birth certificate out to you. And this is the day that your insides is being born again. And all I want to ask you is, do you want to live? Do you want to live? Yeah. Do you want to live?
No, I laugh when you say, and I'm giving you because I know you are giving. You will give the shirt off your back. I thought she was going to say, and you get a car, and you get a car, you get a car.
Prophesy, prophesy, because that day is coming. Hey, prophesy. Yes, God. Yes, God. Prophesy that thing.
I'm
says,
telling
hey,
you, but you're a giver.
I feel like I got to get up and lay.
They need 30 seconds for us to come back so we can get
there. Oh, we will. But before they come back, because we're going into this next segment, I want to ask the number one question. There is a team, Pastor Boyd, and there is a team, Gail Johnson. We, Dr. Gail Johnson, we are taking both of them for the first 3 months on this journey. When we measure Pastor and Dr. Johnson, going to give us their clothes. We're going to seal the clothes in a box, and the next time they open those clothes to try them on, it would be every 30 days to see if they are losing.
God, he got away.
And I said,
no, this right here gonna do it.
No, I told him, I said, you know the pictures that he used to show me and you when he used to bust concrete and football? I said, that little Hercules is down in there screaming to get out.
The other day.
I said, it's trying to come out.
Honey, so, I want him to come back.
Yeah. Oh, you want him to come back?
I want him to come back.
Come back to Jamaica.
No, I can't be doing this. And you don't be looking like,
yes.
Oh, this is great.
No.
Oh. And you know, prophets, anytime you do anything for 3 weeks, you're set.
You're set.
That's all you need.
So it's
you're
3 months, and it's going to be team Pastor Boyd and team Dr. Johnson. And we would like to know your answer. Whose team are you on?
I'm on my husband's team.
Oh, my dear.
You better go. He going to eat his words in the preach. He said, manna. We're going to give you a lot of manna. And what's that season?
Coriander. Coriander.
Hallelujah. Amen. It is done. I am so happy. You know, he needed this because me and the kids, we were very concerned. And, you know, Pastor, you know, you got to walk. Some of us, you got to take us by the hand.
Right.
And
right.
I believe not only that you're taking my husband and Dr. Johnson by the hand, you're taking the world by the hand. You're telling them that they can do it, and they're going to do it, and they'll never be the same, and they're going to live.
No.
So God can get the glory out of what they're doing.
That's right. Okay. And so the number one question on this broadcast is, do you want to live? We're going to a commercial. We'll be right back.
Oh, my God. This is definitely
Lord have mercy. That was great. That was great. you got to sit on here with me sometime. I told him, you ain't going to be my permanent. And now I got this job. I said, don't try to bring yourself on permanently. Then maybe some days you can do it with me. Be good.
Amen. This right here. Yes. It's done.
Mm. No, he's already losing.
Lift your hands and tell him that it's done.
It's done.
Tell him what you shall be.
Well, I shall be.
You already are. God's already worked it out.
Yes, he has.
And on your behalf.
Yes, he has.
Your eyes may not see it. Come on, Pastor.
My eyes may not see
by
it.
By faith.
By faith.
You believe it.
I believe it.
We believe it.
You'll believe it.
It will manifest.
It will manifest.
Look at somebody and say, it will manifest. And tell him because it's already done. Oh, come on, put your hands together and bless. Hallelujah.
Everybody that's watching by internet, this is my very colorful pastor and his wife. We have an awesome church. You got to visit us at the New Greater Bethel Ministries. I'm telling you, where God is giving life and life more abundantly. Yes, somebody give God a praise for my girl. Yeah, the happy dance.